Hey Arivu people, today we are going to do 7th grade module 2, and this is the first session of the 3 sessions that we will be doing. So for this session or for this module, we are going to be dealing with the prose chapter Journey to the Top, and it is a story about Bachchandri Pal, who is the first woman from India to climb the Mount Everest. So for the opening, what we are going to do is we are going to introduce the character to the students. Now, to introduce a character to the students, we are going to do a quick newspaper activity, which is we are going to tell the students that they are going to make a newspaper article about this character. To start off, we can even show them pictures of Bachchandri Pal and tell the students who she is in like a sentence or two. And then what you are going to do is we are going to distribute newspaper articles that were of earlier times of Bachchandri Pal and distribute among the students. So we have old newspaper articles from the Hindu and other newspapers, and we are going to give this to students so that they can read and understand the character. And we are also going to give them a handout, which is a text itself, where they again will find a lot of information about this character. And now we are also going to show them a few sample newspapers, and then what we are going to do is tell them to make their own newspaper. So for this activity, we will also be giving them like stickers and sketch pins, papers, chart papers, whatever they want, so that they can make a newspaper. Make sure it's not too elaborate, but like a short piece, because we're just going to give them one newspaper article to work on. So for this activity, what we're going to do is give them an idea of how a newspaper looks like. So maybe what you can do, you can draw this on the board and just tell them that this is how it's going to look like. So first they have to come up with a heading for the newspaper. So they're going to name the newspaper, whatever name. So give them examples like the Hindu, the Indian Express, and tell them you can now think of a name for your newspaper as well. So you let them write the name for the newspaper in the top. Then what they can do is you're going to give them stickers of the character. So they stick the sticker in this paper. And then they are going to write a newspaper article with all this information that they have received from different articles and from the textbook handout also. So they have to make like a short article and also write in there. So they write the article here in the newspaper. So they're just making this section of a newspaper. They're not going to make the entire newspaper, but just this one section in the newspaper. Now if there is time, you can encourage them to like put in advertisements. So maybe we have a newspaper sample, show them these newspapers and show them how their advertisements in newspapers, and in case they can come up with something, they can draw pictures of something and make an advertisement here. So that's again up to them if they have the time, and if they want to ask them to be as creative as possible and make their own newspaper. And the newspaper article should be something that they are writing by themselves. It shouldn't be from the textbook or from the other newspaper articles. Those are just reference for information, but the students will have to come up with their own article, and then towards the end of the session they can show this newspaper article to the other classmates as well. So this is how we will open the session, by introducing the character Bachchandri Pal. Now for the main creation, what we are going to do is we are going to play a question game. So for this question game, you're going to split the class into two groups. So once you split the class into two groups, you have to number all the students in both the teams. So this, for example, you have to number them like how we number in the game Dog and the Goon. There are two teams and both the teams get numbers. Now they're going to be same numbers. For example, there are 20 students, you split them into two. The first team has 10, the second team has 10. So you start from 1 to 10 for both the teams. So from both the teams, they'll have the same numbers. Now what you do is, this game is very similar to the Dog and the Bone game. So the classroom structure, this is how it's going to look like. So this is group 1. This is group 2. And you have everybody standing here. So there's 1... 2, 3, as many students are there, you just number them on both sides. Now the facilitator has to stand in between with a sheet of paper with a lot of sentences from the text. So this is the handout that you have received. So the person in between, the facilitator standing in between both the groups, or you can even keep a table there and keep these questions in between. Now what the facilitator is going to do is call out a number. And when you call out a number, both the students from both the teams have to come in front. And what they're going to do is they're going to frame a question for the sentence. Now what you have to do is also keep two blank sheets for both the teams. So they both come forward, they quickly read the sentence, and now what they're going to do is they're going to frame a sentence. For example, one statement is, Bachchandri Pal was born in 1954 at Nakhuri. So what they're going to do is both the students come forward and they frame a question. For example, where was Bachchandri Pal born? So both of them will come together and in their separate sheets, write the questions and go back. So I'll just repeat that quickly. So you, for example, I'm the facilitator. I call number 5. The student from first team and the second team, number 5 comes forward. They see the question. You have to show them the question. Show them the question. And then they frame the question. So you show them the sentence. They frame the question and they go back. So you call out different numbers and make sure you don't repeat the same students. Call out different students. Let them come forward, write the question and go back. And once everybody is done and all the sentences are done, you can just go through the sheets quickly and tell them how many questions were right and how many were wrong. So for this activity, you just have to make sure that they're getting the right question. So just tell them after the whole game is over that how they could modify the questions to make it right. So this will actually help them to frame questions for an answer. This is the objective of the game. And this is the first part of the main creation. Now for the second part of main creation, we are going to play a game which is a combination of Dhamsharads and Pictionary. So for this, the facilitator has a handout. This is the facilitator handout that you have received. And these are different phrases that are related to the chapter itself. And what you are going to do is the classes into 5 to 10 groups. This is again based on your number. See how you can split the class. If it's a very small class, even 3 groups will do. If it's a huge class, make it like 8 groups, 9 groups, or even 10 groups. And now what they're going to do is you give them a phrase from this handout. And the person who is a representative will have to act it out just like Dhamsharads. So they act it out and the rest of the team will have to guess. Now in case they're not able to guess, then the person who's acting has an option of drawing a picture. So they give them a paper or even the board and they draw a picture and the team has to guess what he is drawing. So this is going to be like a combination. So first the option is they can only do Dhamsharads, so they have to act it out. If they cannot guess the word or the phrase, and then you give them the option to draw. So this is the second part of the main creation. Now for the third part of main creation, we are going to do this game called 2-in-1. So for 2-in-1, again you're going to split the class into 10 groups. And for this game, again you're going to give them a sheet of paper with different sentences on it. So you're going to give them this sheet with different sentences. So basically every point has 2 sentences. Okay, this is one pair of sentences. And what you're going to do, there's also going to be a display sheet with different connecting words. And these are conjunctions. So basically they're going to see these 2 sentences and they're going to use one of these conjunctions and they're going to join and make one big sentence. So for example, one pair of sentences, I like coffee, I don't like tea. Now what they're going to do is they're going to look at a display sheet with a lot of conjunctions and they're going to figure out which conjunction will fit for this sentence. So I like coffee, I don't like tea can be I like coffee but I don't like tea. So the word but will be in the display sheet which they will have to pick because there are so many conjunctions in this display sheet. They have to pick the right conjunction and they have to use in these sentences and make full-fledged sentences. So they have two sentences. Every sentence has to be reframed and made into one sentence using the conjunctions that they can see on the display sheet. Now for facilitator reference, we're also giving you an answer key. So make sure that after they do the activity that you go around and check the sentences that they have filled and see if they have got it right. So please go through the answer key because we have framed the sentences with the appropriate conjunctions. So make sure the students have got it right. If they have gotten it wrong, just repeat it to them and tell them how you can use these conjunctions in a sentence, and that's how the and show them the appropriate conjunction that they need to use after the activity is over. So this is how we'll end the name creation. Now for the closure, what you're going to do is you're going to play a game called Find the Object. Now this is another game that we have played in the office and during our training. So this is something that we all will remember. So what you're going to do is you guys have the paper bag or the carton box. What you're going to find different things within the classroom. You know, you have like paint bottles, pens, stickers, paper, or duster, or anything that you can find, put it into this bag. And I'm going to be blindfolding one child. This person who's blindfolded will come forward and he will be sitting in front of his back with all these objects. Now what you're going to do is ask this student to look for any one object and describe this object. So for example, if there's a marker and I can't see it, so I just feel it and I realize it's a marker because I'm blindfolded. So I feel it and I'm like, okay, I know it's a marker. So I will have to describe it, but I cannot say that it is a marker. So I can say things like, this is something that you used to write on the board. It's black in color, there's green color, and we can even erase it. So then you would guess saying chalk piece, and you say, no, it has ink in it. Then I would say, okay, it's also something with a cap that you can close like a pen. Then the students will have to guess saying, okay, it might be a marker, a whiteboard marker. So this is how we're going to play this game. So split the class into groups again, based on the number of students you have, and pick a representative from every team. Ask them to sit in front, blindfold them. So please make sure you take a scarf before you go to the session. Blindfold the student and ask them to feel the object that is in the box or in the bag and describe it, but they cannot say what the object is, and the team members have to guess what the object is. So this is just a fun game to end the session. Make sure it is exciting, and they actually, and at least more, a few students get turned to come in front and describe the object that is in the bags. And use different objects that you find in the classroom. It can be anything that you find around in the class, even outside, whatever you can collect, just bring it for this activity. So this is how we'll end this session 1 for module 2 for 7th grade. Thank you.